So many of my startup businesses are single member LLCs, and it's usually because it involves just one person. Now we're gonna get into kind of the comparisons. What's a single member LLC? What are multi-member LLCs? But I'm gonna go through the most essential tips that you guys need to know so that you can have an efficient, successfully run LLC. And we're gonna go through all of it in under 5 minutes. Hi guys, I'm Miss Crystal. I'm an entertainment attorney, public speaker, and author of How to Keep Your Dukes Up in the Music Business. I'm the owner of Dukes Up Records, and most importantly, I'm an independent musician. Be sure to turn on those bell notifications so you don't miss our weekly videos helping you with your careers, understanding business tactics, and really getting you to that next level. You guys are gonna get some really helpful information from this video about single member LLCs and protecting yourself as far as how you operate your LLC, but we're working on a course right now, which is really a deep dive in everything you need to know about setting up a music business on trademarks, copyright, music contracts, and really deep diving into everything that you need to know. So make sure you click that link down in the description to sign up to get on our early notification list to learn about when that course is coming out. To kick it all off, what's a limited liability company, aka LLC? An LLC basically is to protect you if you get sued. It's a liability shield, and it's in place so that, let's say you lose in a lawsuit and now you owe some money. Well, instead of you personally owing the money, your company is the one that's gonna owe it. And in some cases where it's a real big debt, you know, it's gonna be one of those situations where everything kind of goes down in flames. So, you know, sad to lose an LLC, but it's one of those kind of tactics that we have so that we can protect ourselves, protect our personal finances. And so you create this liability shield by registering an LLC. So what's a single member LLC? A single member LLC is basically you. That means there's no one else in the company. You're the boss, you're the decision maker, and there's no other partners or investors, right? So if then we have a multi-member LLC, we do usually have those other partners or investors. And then that means there's more people helping with decision-making and the operation of the business, and that's fine. Most of my clients are gonna grow to that at some point, but really a lot of startups usually involve just one person in the beginning. So once you decide you're gonna register your LLC, you're gonna do it in the state that you live, and usually that's where you're conducting your business. And so you're gonna do it through usually the Secretary of State. Most people can do this themselves. It can be kind of, you know, wonky as far as finding paperwork and filing. So you can get help. I do this for my clients, but either way, if you wanna do it yourself, that's fine. So you find the paperwork, you file it, you pay the fee, and then you'll register your LLC. Once you have an LLC, the next step is that you're actually gonna go and get what's called an EIN number through the IRS website, irs.gov. You just Google, you know, EIN number, but you can get that basically in under 10 minutes. And it operates essentially like a social security number for your company, and you need it to do the following step, which is to open a bank account. So you have your LLC, you got your EIN number, now you're opening your bank account in the name of the business. And one of the best tips that you're ever gonna hear from me, make sure with your bank account that you always, always, always only use it for business purposes. Do not double dip, do not cross-pollinate and have funds coming in from different business ventures, your personal stuff, or, you know, paying for expenses out of the business account for personal stuff. Just don't do it. That's gonna give the appearance that you actually don't treat your business like a real company. And so it's gonna get you into some trouble when you actually try saying, hey, I'm a real company, I need this liability shield. So don't weaken your position. Make sure you're using that bank account only for the business at all times. And then you can get into some additional formal steps like having documents for the business, right? So you have something called an operating agreement. The operating agreement is essentially the rules of the road for the company, right? So if you are a multi-member company, if you have three people who are involved in decision-making and paying for expenses and, you know, different things that happen with the business, it's really helpful to actually have a contract between all the members that say who does what, including what happens with the bank account, who gets to spend money. So the operating agreement is really helpful. And even if you are a single member LLC, still put one into place, because again, it's that extra layer of showing you take yourself seriously, you are a legit business, and, you know, it's just going to put you in a better position if someone ever was to challenge whether your business is legit or not. And another thing, of course, are meeting minutes, right? So if you're having a meeting and you're making decisions about things, just kind of typing things in a Word document and noting what happened, what was voted on, really helpful when you have multi-member LLCs. But again, you can do it even if you are a single member LLC, and you really should. Not required in most states, but again, just from kind of planning for the future, if something was to go wrong, always a good idea. So that was your overview of having a single member LLC and those critical steps that you guys need to make sure that you're doing to stay liability proof and to have that protection. Now, like I said, I'm gonna have a full length course coming at you, so make sure you sign up to get on our email list, link down in the description below. If you're in the mood for some dark pop music, be sure to check out Miss Crystal on all music platforms. I just dropped my full-length album, Dangerous Daughters, as well as a music video, Holy Water, which I will be sure to link at the end of the video. Be sure to come say hi on social media. I'm definitely the most active on Instagram, but really, come say hi anywhere. It's been amazing to meet you guys. I'm gonna get out of here, but thank you for watching. Be sure to subscribe, turn on those bell notifications so you don't miss any videos from your new favorite redhead. I'm Miss Crystal. Bye.